Al.
And welcome back to our Minecraft Let's Play All World Revive. Yeah, today we are going to... Today we are going to open the uncommon bags here. There we go. Go over here to our little place underneath the lucky chandelier. We got our that one on, and let's start to open, shall we? Let me just don't want to do this. Gonna do this. Gonna put them down here like so. Okay. I have so many diamonds! Okay, what did we get? What did we get? I'm hoping for a very special item. But I think we can only get that in the rare pouch. Whoop. Oh shit. Damn. Nausea effect, I hate nausea effect. But it will disappear. Okay, 31 diamonds and 38 emeralds. That's actually quite a cool thing. I'm just gonna do that so I don't accidentally toss more bad effect potions on me. Invisibility. Lol. Many things such wow. Potion of night vision. Ah, experience potions, nice. 60 diamonds, 64. Holy crap. Okay, last four stacks. Almost drank weakness. Damn. Okay. Damn, bro. 10 experience bottles, 33 knowledge shards. Go. Okay, nothing new to report here. Oh, that was another 16 ender pearls. Okay. Another 16 ender pearls there, damn. We got ender pearls for days. Golden apple, enchanted golden apple, nice. Another 16 ender pearls. Oh! I just saw a really good helmet. Another 16 ender pearls, a stack of gold. Another 16 ender pearls. Damn. Endless Dagger, 16 Ender Pearls. Damn, son. Not a stack of 16 Ender Pearls? Fuck. A stack of emeralds? Nice. Not a stack of ender pearls and a stack of gold. 6 diamonds. Now we are just about, I can see we're just about reaching the end here. Yeah, there we go. Damn, that was a lot. A lot of sweet items. Kate. 11k of these gold coins, dudes. Damn. Nice. Uh, 1300 diamonds, sweet. Yeah. We still got the 23 rares. We can, yeah. Oh, let's take these 7 out here just for funsies. Nice. Okay. Yeah. Thormium helmet, guys. Dang it. We did have, we also had a fountain book in here. Oh, let's see, that should be under here, right? Yeah, what's this? Oh, this is Thormium Fortress gear, Thormium helmet. Oh, it's just a simple one, nothing too spectacular. It's a shame. I don't know about the. I had hoped that the. This. Oh, wait a minute, wait a minute, wait a minute. I know exactly what we're gonna make. We're gonna make this one. That's a Konic Evolution Information Tablet. Bam. Knowledge to the max. Draconic Evolution. I am still in the process of adding documentation to this manual. There is also some fine-tuning that I still need to do. Cool. Draconic Core Dust. Ore Dust. All of the above. Oh, and then you can scroll down. Riven Helmet. Yeah. You make it like that. Hold Shift Click. Yeah. Back. Okay. Souls, the bigger tools, the better armor. Weather control. This is a block that allows you to control the weather. to use it, place some emeralds in its inventory and set a mode. There are three available modes: rain off, rain on, and thunderstorm. To activate, apply a redstone signal. Sweet. Mob stabilize, yeah. Stabilize mob spawners. Crystal binder. Rain sensor, probably. A device that emits a red sheen signal, yeah, redstein signal when it rains. This is perfect for controlling the weather controller. Yeah, precisely. Reaper enchantment, energy storage, multi-block. The Reaper enchantment increases the drop chance of souls from mobs. It has a max level of 5 and is also and it also makes it possible for regular weapons to drop souls from mobs. Okay, cool. Energy storage, multi-block. Ritual, ooh. One ritual stone, the one in the middle. Four glowstone, four obsidian. Four diamonds, four charged draconium blocks. I think that's just draconium, and then we just have to charge it somehow. And 12 quartz pillars. Set it in the following configuration. The pillars don't have to be in that exact configuration, as long as there are within 5 blocks of the ritual stone. It also looks better if they are symmetrical. Yeah, if the ritual must be set up within 150 blocks of 00, that's in the end. That's where you spawn when we jump into the end. The place you spawn in the end, that's 00. Once you have set up, simply right click the ritual stone and stand back. The ritual should start immediately. If it doesn't, you have done something wrong. Cracking the ritual stone again will stop the ritual and drain the charge from the draconium blocks. Of course, then you have to, yeah. Doing the ritual, all of the ender crystals will be reactivated. Yeah, at the end of the ritual, there will be a massive explosion at the center of this structure that won't do much. That won't do too much damage to the terrain, but will kill anything that is standing too close. The dragon that is spawned by the ritual is almost identical to the original dragon, except it has a different texture by a great order. And it gets harder to kill and deals more damage each time it is summoned. The increase is per player and stops when it reaches a certain difficulty. It also has regeneration for 25 seconds. Nice. Pigment, blood, rage, comments. Oh, mine out all of the draconium, or in the end, get yourself some from a flying. Get yourself some from of flight and. Go search the end. If you are lucky, you may come across an ender comment. These comments are composed of endstone, obsidian, and a significant amount of draconium ore. By default, they have a 1 in 1,000 chance to spawn in each chunk, so you may need to search for a while. They come in various sizes. Oh, nice! Chaos Island. Looking for a challenge? The Ender Dragon wasn't hard enough. This is for you. If you travel to any multiple of a 10,000 in the end, apparently, you will find a Chaos Island. Each of these islands is guarded by a Chaos Guardian, which is basically an extremely powerful Ender Dragon that drops 2 Dragon Hearts and some draconium dust as well as the standard end portal in the middle of the island, with the egg on top of it. Note that Chaos Island is a work in progress, and there will be chances of failure, of course. Placing items in the world. Yeah, we know. I know that one already. Oh, this is so cool! Conum Tiestu, we have seen that one before. Stabilize Mothra. To get started, right-click any vanilla mob, any vanilla spawner with a Draconium Core to stabilize it. You now have an empty transportable spawner. Pick it up with Draconium Tools. Use any mob soul on the spawner to change it to that type. There are several items you can use to upgrade the spawner. Vivon Core upgrades to tier 2. Increase spawning count and speed. Awakened Core upgrade to tier 3 further increases spawn count and speed. Netherstar removes the requirement for a player to be within 16 blocks for the spawner to function. Notch Apple, meaning that the Enchanted Apple, makes the spawner ignore spawn requirements for the mob it is spawning. It will monster spawn even if the light level is too high. When broken, you get back everything except the mob soul. It is too fragile and is destroyed when the spawner is broken. Okay, so all of the upgrades you will get back except the mob soul, which is a-okay with me. Cool. But I want that enchantment up here. Tool crafting guide. This guide is used to configure most draconic evolution tools and armor. The default key to open this guide is C. When you open the guide, you will see all the items in your inventory. Items that can be configured will be highlighted. When you click on one of the highlighted items, you will see a list of settings specific to that item that you can adjust. You can also use the GUI to apply and remove enchantment in the list of options for the item there. Yeah, I know that. That's the thing that bugs my game out. Okay. Where was the... There we go. This one. I want this this enchantment here. Reaper enchantment. Which I don't have on this one right now. Can I get it here? Protection, fire protection. Aquifinity thorns might knock back. Looting. Unbreaking fortune, power punch, infinity flame, lure, repair. I don't think we get it here, no. Fire aspect, looting, efficiency, silver, fortune, punch, power, flame, infinity, lure. No, we've just been passive. Okay. Then how do I get it? How do I get it? This one doesn't say, right? It doesn't say how to get it. energy infuser. Seeing the need for faster energy transfer, you have found a way to bring the infuser to being has a faster transfer rate than most other mods. RF recharge station and cool particular effect to boot. Okay, so Draconic Core. Okay, that is that one. Okay, cool. That, an enchantment table, and then this one. Which also requires Draconic Core. Should we try and make it? Yeah, let's make that the infuser thingy. Okay, so... Whoops. 1, 2, 3, 4 Draconic Cores, right? Yeah. We already have 4 Draconic Cores. Okay, cool. An enchantment table and a particular generator. Okay. An enchantment table. Bam. and this one. Yeah. And now we should be able to make the draconic core. Or the draconic infusion. Yeah. Nice. Okay. Let's set it down and just have a look. Okay, of course it needs power. But damn, that thing looks amazing. Yeah. Okay, cool. Let us go down here and let's set it down here somewhere. Whoop. Okay, yeah. Just have a look, see. You know what, let's try something here. Let's just plug it right down on top of here. Whoop. Bam. Zoom. Nice. Zoom. Done. Okay, yeah. Oh, wait a minute. Nice. Now the armor doesn't show any durability loss on it. Nice. Okay. There you go. I gotta figure out how to. I'm probably going to make a special. ENDRIO. Yeah, we need these. The green ones. Yeah. Do I have any left of those? Let me just check. I got 5 left of those. Okay. Oh. Oh, that was lucky. That goes up to here. Okay. Then it goes up to here. Yeah. Okay. I'm thinking that, yeah, we're not even up close yet. This up here is how I need to go up. So, we need a little bit more than that. Okay. Can I place this thing on the... Can I place this thing on the wall? Wouldn't it be cool if it could be placed on the wall? It could be placed like that. Okay, let me just... yoink. Can I turn it? Oh, I can't. It doesn't respond to any of those. Okay. Just gonna leave it there for now. Pretty cool. Pretty cool machine. Pretty cool looking thing. But yeah. Oh, that's the wrong one. That one. Okay, maybe we should. I'm just gonna pluck that. Nope, I still wanna read a little bit on it. Yeah. Ah. Let's see. Charm of dislocation, yeah. Enchanted charm. Basically, this is a teleporter. It uses ender pearls to teleport you. And requires that ribbon core. Actually, we can make that now, can't we? Let me see if I can't make that one now. Yeah. Okay, this one. That's easy enough to make. Achievement gained. Enderman has nothing on me. Okay. This one requires 4 of these. And then Ender Star. There we have it. BND. Ender Pearls. Just gonna grab a nice bit of them. 0 fuel. Add fuel. Cool. Okay, let us say that I want to stand right here. Click it. Add new place. Call home base. There you go. Okay. Shift. Remember shift click this one. Remove. Lock. I got 151. And how much does this cost? Just one ender pearl from there. But then I could, let's say, to the nether, our, how you doing? And I want to stand right here, looking, facing out there. Shift, click, add new. NETHER, nether. Commit. Lock. Okay. Shift. Mouse wheel. Scrolls between the two. Home base. Only cost one ender pearl, guys. Shift. Mouse wheel. Now this is how you get around. How you doing? Cool. And was it this one? Yeah, it was. Nice. So much fun. And out of that, we already got 4 wither skeletons and another bag of loot. Bam, baby. Okay. Shift right click. Add fuel. Cool. Damn, now this is how we get around. Sweet. Well, yeah. Oh, I think it's about time we wrapped up this little escapade raid here. I'm thinking that I might do something. Yeah, we're gonna have to do something with that. Do something cool. So yeah, thank you all so very much for watching. Happy weekend. Hope you had an awesome weekend. I will, of course, be streaming here a little bit later. Streaming some World of Warcraft dungeon grinds and raids and stuff like that. And yeah, please do join me over there. I will, of course, have a video up when I'm streaming, of course. So yeah. Again, thank you all so very much for watching. And as always, catch you on the flip side.